I just knew in my heart that it was only God. Nobody can tell me it's a coincidence. I will fight that person. You don't understand. It was really deep for me as a person. Back to Sunshine's Paradise. This is Sunshine and you are most welcome. So guys, we'll be doing something really deep today. We'll be talking about true life personal miracles. Yes, I'll be talking about my personal life miracles with you all so that we'll know how awesome and mighty God is. But before then guys, you know the drill. If you have not subscribed, please subscribe to my channel and give it a like. Leave your comments directly below this video. Let me know what your thoughts are about the video and make sure you share with your friends. It really means a lot to me and it will help this YouTube channel grow, and I would appreciate you all for it. Thank you. So guys, I've been thinking about doing this for a while because it's really deep for me. I will not be able to share a whole lot, but the little I can, you guys will bear with me and enjoy. Not just enjoy, learn from it because it's deep, like I said. So most times, we, especially as I'm talking about as Christians now, we tend to see God as only working mightily and greatly during the time of old. But we tend to forget the little things God does for us. And we overlook, or sometimes we call it coincidence, when in the real sense, it's actually God's mighty power at work in our lives, and we should never take it for granted. Before I go further, guys, if you hear any background noise, please, I apologize. Thank you. So the first personal life miracle I'll be sharing with you is while I was 3 years old. I was so little then. In fact, I was, you know, the story was told to me by my parents. So I was told that while I was at that age, I fell sick, really sick. I'm talking about really sick. I mean, my both parents are medical practitioners. However, this sickness was on another level because they had done everything they could do medically that they thought should have helped me and, you know, helped me recover back to health, but it wasn't working. So at a point, my dad was the one telling me, and you know, when he was saying it, like, I could see the depth of how deep it was for them, you know, as parents. I was their only child then, you get. So they decided to take a step, and the step they took was to leave me in the pastor's house, like in their pastor's house, the church they attended then. They left me there. They were like they got to that crossroad where they felt, see, if God is not going to heal her, then that's it, like we're done, because we don't know what else to do. We've done everything possible that we can do as parents for this girl and she's not getting better. So they left me there, and according to the story, it wasn't long after they left me there, I started recuperating back to health. So I don't know how you can call that coincidence, because everything medically possible they had done already, until after they left me at the pastor's house, who obviously kept on praying for me and everything, and then I recovered back to health. So that is my number one life personal miracle that God has done for me. I mean, even if I can't remember anyone, anytime I remember that one, it jacks up my faith and I'm like, if God can do that for me at that little age, because I don't even, like, I can't even remember, then it means God is awesome and he has a purpose, you know, he has a purpose why I am alive, and he has, you know, great things he wants me to achieve. So it got me, you know, wowed in my faith. Now the second instance is a very funny one. I was in uni already, I think I was in 200 level or so. So this day I was broke, I mean, flat ass broke. And I wanted to get something in town. It's a village, but we call it town. So I wanted to get something in town. And while I left my campus, I mean, the only money I took along was my transport to the ATM point. And they just, you know, the ATM was new there because it's a village. That was the only ATM they had. And it was not always working most times. But I was just praying in my heart that God, like, Because I took my ATM, that if this ATM was not dispensed, like I'm in deep shit, like there was no POS or anything of sorts in the village then. So that was like my only hope, except if I was going to go to Ondo, which is the next town, and it was a while away. So I was like, no, I can't do it. I got there and I met people there leaving, saying that the ATM was not working. I was like, hey, my own, I was like, how will I even go back? Because it was only transport to the ATM point that I had on me. And I prayed in my heart. I was just like, God, just favor me. God, favor me. That's just the silent prayer I prayed in my heart. And where people were living, I went there and the ATM dispensed for me. Guys, it's no joke. It might seem ordinary to you people, but no, it was a big deal for me because, I mean, I had nothing on me any longer. And I was not in the habit of borrowing from people. So I was just like, God, please. And he answered my prayer. I'm like, I don't see, it doesn't have to be wow. Most times the testimonies doesn't have to be like something that would shake everybody. So far it shakes you as a person, I think that's what really counts. So it just made me worship God more and recognize his power the more. So the third instance, how I knew, you know, God was just wonderful, it was a life personal miracle for me, was during the production of Evo. If you've not seen Evo, please go and see it. It's still up on my channel. So guys, during production of Evo, on the day of shooting, that's our last day of shooting, we're supposed to sleep over at my place, like every the cast member and the crew members. And there was no light. Now my area, the light there is very bad. I was hoping on the gen. Now the gen I was hoping on, you know, they tried putting it on and it wasn't working. It was coming on, but it was not, you know, transmitting light. And I was like, God, what am I going to do? Everybody was on ground, like there was no any other option, and there was no light. Because like I said, I was not even depending on the light, because I know the light is very bad in my area. And I just kept praying. I don't know if anyone noticed, among other cast members, I went to the wall outside in the compound and I prayed in my heart. Like a word did not come out of my mouth. I just prayed in my heart and I was just speaking in tongues inside me, and I was just like, God, except if you don't want this production to happen, if you have a hand in it, if you're the one that directed me to do this, then please just let everything work for my favor. Everyone is on ground. I can't just, you know, dispense everybody. We don't know when next we'll be able to have time to be able to do the shooting. So I was so scared. And so I don't know, something in me just said, oh, okay, let everyone of us just pray together. So we prayed together. No, before we pray together, I, you know, try to encourage everybody, thanking them for coming on board for the project and all that. And we prayed together, everyone. And I'm not joking, guys, I'm not exaggerating. So it was not up to 5 minutes after the prayer, NEPA brought light. And this one that NEPA brought light, it stayed until we were done with the shooting, which was around 2 or 3 a.m. the next day. Even when we were done, the light was still around for another 1 hour before they now took the light. And the next day in the morning when we needed the light, it still came again. It was until we were done before they took the light. Guys, I'm serious. Anyone that knows my area knows the light is very bad. But that period we needed it, it worked. And I just knew in my heart that it was only God. Nobody can tell me it's a coincidence. I will fight with that person. You don't understand. It was really deep for me as a person. And it just, you know, got me thinking. And I thought, let me share the story with you guys, because I don't know who I will be encouraging. So guys, those are the three instances I will be discussing as my life personal miracles. Feel free to share yours in the comment section. Let's celebrate how powerful and how awesome God is, because he's worthy to be praised, he's worthy to be adored. Don't wait until you get, you know, rescued from a kidnapper before you realize, oh, God actually does miracles. Those minor things you don't count are actually a big deal, guys. So thank you very much. If you watched up to this point, thank you very much. Don't forget to subscribe in case you forgot to subscribe at first when you started watching the video. And make sure you leave a comment and share with your friends. You don't know who these testimonies would encourage. So yeah. Thank you, thank you, thank you very much. And see you in the very, very next video. I love you guys.